Hey guys, Decav13 here, and welcome back to some more Let's Play Fire Emblem Fates Conquest. In the last episode, we made our way through Chapter 19, Kitsune Village, I believe. I'm probably fucking all these chapter titles. Anyway, on our way through Hoshido to get to the capital, we had a choice to make. Either to go through a road that we know that the Hoshiden army is going to be fortifying very heavily, or up a mountain that there were going to be no Hoshiden soldiers on. So we chose the mountain, naturally. Unfortunately, while up there, we accidentally wandered into a Kitsune village, and we had to fight them to the death, because they were ready to kill us, because they thought we were going to try and take their fur, which is completely reasonable. I mean, they do have nice fur and poachers. Anyway, I'm getting really off topic, which is strange for me in an intro. Let's go. Of course, first, as usual, yada yada yada, support conversations. We got a bunch of these to do. So, yeah, actually, let's start with Jane and Shora, rank C. So this is where you've been hiding. Lady Jane.
Why are you way out here? You know that everyone eats in the mess hall, right? You should come over and sup with us.
And sit with us some... Is that
right?
I'm fine here, thank you. Whatever supping with you guys is. I appreciate your graciousness in following me to travel with you, in allowing me to travel with you, m'lady. But as a former outlaw, I don't think I'm fit to dine at your table.
What? Of course you're fit to do so. And I'm sure the others would all agree.
That's very kind of you. Regardless, I would prefer to remain alone.
Why?
It's best I remain in the shadows as much as possible.
In the shadows? What are you talking about?
My face is not unknown. Many people recognize me as an outlaw. If it became widely known I was a part of your group, it would damage your good names. Even if the mess hall is not exactly public, it is still large and rumors spread. A soldier may write to their family, tell their village, and so on.
I don't think...
You can't deny the possibility exists, can you? I have no intention of allowing my presence to hurt your cause. So please try to understand.
Shura.
Now go, rejoin your people. I'm sure they're missing you.
Alright, I will. Good day.
Good day, m'lady.
Alright, Effie and Leo. Effie, you're a marvel on the battlefield. No one is more daring than you. I've watched you annihilate enemies and perform impossible rescues. In the last battle, you took out 10 soldiers with a single thrust of your lance. Then, without so much as a pause, you scaled a tree and rescued a kitten. Where does all that energy come from?
Thanks, m'lord, but I'm just doing my job.
Still, I'm concerned. You're neglecting one of our most valuable assets.
What's that?
You, of course. I'm appalled by the risks you take with your own life.
Sir, my life is worthless if I can't protect the lives of my companions.
Do you really believe others' lives are more valuable than your own?
I would die to protect my friends.
I see. You put others first, always. That is an admirable quality. Effie, I won't let you down. If you're risking your life, I won't have it be for nothing. I promise I will never send you into battle without a sound plan.
Thank you, Lord Leo. That's all a soldier could ask for.
Oh, boy. Lee some Kaze.
Kaze, let's play!
Hello, Princess Elise. What would you like to do? Shall I play hide and seek again?
Yeah, it's my favorite, and I like playing it with you more than anybody else.
You seem to really love that game. May I ask why that is?
Well, it's probably because I used to play it every day when I was little.
Every day, you say? You must have enjoyed that a great deal.
I did. Well, kind of. Actually, to be honest, most of the time it wasn't fun at all. The person I played with would always fall or trip or something and ruin the game. The other person I always played with would hide in the most obvious places. Sometimes his butt would be sticking out from behind a door. No one has any skill.
Well, at least the camaraderie must have been enjoyable.
Oh, I suppose. But I always wanted to play with someone who's really good.
Is that so?
And now I finally found a worthy opponent. We're pretty much equally matched. I don't say that lightly.
Thank you, m'lady. A ninja could ask for no greater a compliment.
All I ask, Kazei, is that you don't hold back even though I'm a princess. I hate that kind of nonsense, so don't be afraid to show me what you're made of.
I shall not disappoint, m'lady.
It's a promise, then.
I am bound by duty to stay true of my word. I will indeed show you what I'm made of.
Kazei. Alright, Jacob and Camilla.
Jacob, do you have a moment? I feel I must apologize for the other day.
Apology accepted, Lady Camilla.
You're really quite loyal to Jane, aren't you?
Indeed I am. Lady Jane gave me a home when nobody else would. I am happy to serve her until my dying day.
I thought that I was the only one who felt that strongly about Jane.
Certainly not, but I do envy the bond that the two of you share as siblings.
Well, I suppose there's no reason for us to be fighting like this.
I agree wholeheartedly.
And yet I've been so awful to you. Once again, I must apologize, Jacob.
I should also apologize for my tone. Nobody likes an obsequious butler.
Let's stop competing over Jane and focus on protecting her.
Agreed. I will protect her even at the cost of my own life.
Good to know I have such devoted people. Alright, and Gunter and Connor rank B.
Hey, Papa! I've been making so much progress on our contest. What about you?
Well, I've not yet done anything special, but I have received many thanks, as usual. Let's see. Ah, here it is. My tally. Each mark represents one thank you.
Wow, that's a lot! You've got all these already? That's crazy!
Yes, I suppose I never noticed how frequently she thanks me for my duties. Seeing it laid out before me like this is such a wonderful experience. This little piece of paper reassures me that all my efforts have been worthwhile.
Well, I'm still not gonna lose. Here, see? I recorded all mine, too. And the total is,
Oh, you have the same number as I do. I'm impressed, Connor. Well done.
I do! Connor's gonna beat you big time. After all, I don't have to work, so I can spend all day doing things for Mama.
Quite the clever one, aren't you? And what exactly have you been doing for her, exactly?
Mostly I've been trying to help out around camp. I spend each morning making arrows for the Fletchers. Then at lunch I chop the bear meat for the cooks and hand out the food. Oh, and at night I make sure the mounts are all fed and outfitted for the next day. Plus I do a bunch of other little things whenever I have time.
That is quite a lot of work. And you've been doing this every day? You've really grown up, haven't you?
Huh?
Oh, just a thought. Perhaps I've been treating you like too much of a child as well. It wasn't that long ago that you were just a little babe in swaddling clothes. And now, all of a sudden, you're making real important contributions to the army.
Hehe, I've been working real hard. Soon there'll be nothing I can't do.
I believe it. Truly, I do. I imagine Jane is very grateful for all the hard work you've been doing.
Good work. I just realized, Mama hasn't actually been saying thank you to me very much. She just tells me good work and smiles. It's kind of a sad smile, come to think of it.
I wouldn't overthink it too much. You are truly doing good work, and I am very proud of you.
I guess you're right. I'll just have to work even harder for Mama tomorrow. I'm not gonna lose to you, Papa. I won't sleep until Mama thanks me twice as much.
I suppose I'll have to redouble my own efforts if I'm to keep up.
Oh, you two. Alright, let's see what's going around the castle. What's up, benched girl? Here, I have a princess bow.
What's this?
Damn it, that's support.
It's not here either. I was sure I'd find it here.
What's wrong, Nyx? You look upset.
Jane, it's not important.
It looks important enough to you. If there's any way I can help, just tell me.
That's very kind of you. But if you really want to help, you can mind your business and stay out of my problems.
I'm sorry, I didn't mean to pry.
No harm done. You're young enough that I expect you can't help it.
Me? Young?
Unless I missed my guess, I'm clearly older than you.
Are you through speaking?
Yes.
Perhaps I was too harsh. I know your intentions were good. But when a lady has a secret to keep, don't go digging for answers. Be mindful of that in the future.
Understood.
Good. Now go.
Well, that's what I get for trying to help. Alright, we got...
Hi, Mama.
Aw, hey, baby. Alright, let's see if our little son can help us. Come on. Yes!
Wow!
Yes. And we got a silver dagger. Ooh.
See ya.
Thank you, Kana. Yo, I think Kana rigged the lottery for us. Alright, so let's get rid of this steel dagger on Jacob. And let's give him the silver dagger. Oh, that's satisfying. Ooh. I just ran right through that berry garden. What else is going on?
Alright!
Search for Felicia. Oh, it's a shame I'm not using you on this path. No, let's take a bath, too. Before we go, do the other stuff. Oh, okay. I actually got it right this time.
What a workout.
It's the weirdest thing, but hitting the baths always makes me hungry. This is just the thing for sore muscles.
This is just the thing after working up a sweat on the battlefield.
I can hear my overworked muscles thanking me for the break. Indeed.
This is a safe place to relax.
Ah, let's not keep staring. I think I've been here long enough. Alright, so let's go do the arena now. Who we got?
Such
Niles.
Fine.
Let's see. Let's bet Lapis. And we'll send in Selena. A great knight.
Let's make this fun.
Sure, I guess this works.
Loser!
Thanks, Selena.
Put up a fight!
Good job, you two. That 10% crit really helped. Now let's call it there. You know what? Let's get some food. I haven't done that in a while.
I'll do my best.
Benny. Let's see. Let's get defense and resistance.
Sounds good. Here I go.
Have no fear.
This looks edible. I hope you like it.
Standard vegetable tempura. Alright.
To be honest, I think my cooking is way better than this. That meal was nice. I do think that recipe has some untapped potential, though.
This is just like the street food back home. Thanks, it's good.
Defense resistance plus one from the dash. Alright, so we got an extra little boost to defense and resistance. Alright. Let's have us go do this to the private quarters. Let's invite in Leo. If I'd known you were both here, I would have brought a book. You ignore everyone else.
Nice to spend time together while we still can.
Sure, Leo. Alright, let's bond with Gunter.
A kiss to inspire my lady love. I Fear I'm a bit rusty.
Okay. Oh, fuck.
Alright, now that we've done all that stuff, let's move on. Oh wait, we have another support-
Shit!
God damn it.
Leo, can I borrow you for a moment?
Certainly. What do you need? Although you should probably hurry up, because I'm pretty sure we're already 15 minutes in. We should head on to the chapter.
I agree, but we should probably get the support conversation over with.
Alright, what do you need? I was hoping you'd help me study.
You?
Wish to study?
In the middle of a war?
I'm happy to help, but why are you suddenly so serious about your education?
I thought broadening my horizons might help me protect everyone. Now that we're at war, I can practice what I learned right away in a real battle.
The battlefield is not so kind, nor so simple.
I'm sure you've learned that by now, haven't you, Jane?
Well, yes, but...
However, I do think intellectual pursuits play a... I do think intellectual pursuits play a key role in keeping a sharp mind. It can make all the difference in the heat of a battle. If you truly desire it, I will teach you anything you wish to know.
Thank you, Leo.
But don't expect me to go easy on you. You know how strict I am about my studies.
I know, but maybe you could lighten up just a little?
You ask the impossible. I will be as strict as I need to be to help your mind grow. Don't forget, you're the one who sought this out.
I suppose that's true. I'll do whatever you ask of me without complaint.
Spoken like a model pupil. Now, let us begin.
Okay. Now that all the supports are done, let's move on to chapter 20, Winds of Change.
Passing through the mountains, the wind...
Fuck! Me and my selective dyslexia.
Passing through the mountains, the group next encounters the Wind Tribe. Jane tries to convince the leader's tribe's leader to get...
Oh my fucking god. I can't read. Let's try this slower.
Passing through the mountains, the group next encounters the Wind Tribe. Jane tries to convince the tribe's leader to let the group pass without fighting.
There we go, that wasn't so fucking hard.
It's no use, Jane. The Wind Tribe refuses to let us pass through their territory. They said that if we set even one foot on their land, they'll attack. Big meanies.
Don't worry, Elise. We'll figure something out.
This could be trouble.
It's quite bothersome, darling. The Wind Tribe is supposed to be neutral. What's more, cutting through their village is the only safe option we have left. Big ol' liars. They're about as neutral as... No, you know what I mean. They weren't even remotely swayed when Camilla used her feminine wiles on them. That can only mean one thing. They hate Nor. Or women. Or just Norian women. Elise, you silly thing. I did not use wiles of any kind, my love. But you may have a point about them hating Nor. Long ago, their village was attacked by Faceless, sent there by Norian mages. That said, I'm afraid there's probably little we can do to win them over.
Understood.
Well, something must be done. I'm going to try reasoning with them one more time. You are? Oh, little Jane, are you sure that's a good idea?
Yeah.
It's our only option, I'm afraid. If that attack still has them apprehensive, I'll apologize on Nor's behalf. We must earn their trust. Show them that our new way is the way of peace.
Oh, my.
Oh, what a sweet little sister I have. But darling, what if they don't listen? What if they try to attack you? The thought is just too much to bear.
Big sister.
I appreciate your concern, Camilla, but I'll be fine. We must end this war as soon as possible. We haven't a moment to lose. As wielder of the Yato, it is my duty to do whatever I can to bring peace to the world. Wait here for me, okay? This may take a while, but I'm certain we'll eventually come to an understanding. Oh, Jane, be so careful.
Ho! I can see the fierce determination blazing in your eyes, outsider.
Ah, can you? That's good.
Who are you?
I am called Fuga,
chief of the Wind Tribe.
Oh, sorry, I had no idea. I am Princess Jane of Nor. May I request an audience with you?
I was informed there were villagers at the entrance of my village. Not just any outsiders, but ones claiming to be Norian royalty. I am intrigued. It must have taken great courage for a Norian princess to face me like this. I will hear what you have to say.
You will?
Thank you. Yes, but not here. The winds cry out with a ferocity no mortal could hope to rival. We shall venture to my castle, Repu. There your story will be heard. Jane, is it? In time, I will require some information. It's about that blade you grasp. Come.
Huh?
My sword.
That's quite a tale you've told. I believe I understand your aim. Just this once, I will allow your army to pass through this village. I will alert my people that you are welcomed guests who are not to be disturbed.
Thank you.
Thank you so much, sir. Oh, but before I depart, you said there was something you wanted to ask me.
Yes, it is about that golden blade of yours. That is the legendary Yato, is it not?
Oh.
Yes, it is. How did you know?
I used to be close friends with Sumeragi, the former king of Hoshido. I was always enthralled by the various Hoshiden legends he shared with me. The legend behind that blade of yours particularly captured my imagination.
You were friends with the Hoshiden king? But wouldn't that make you our enemy?
No. Calm yourself, young princess. That was many years ago. My tribe has since adopted a policy of neutrality in regard to this war. Though Sumeragi was a friend of mine, we are not allied with Hoshido. However...
Huh?
What's wrong?
Listen well. That divine Yato is the key to the Seal of Flames. Sumeragi once warned me that if it fell into the wrong hands, it would lead to our world's destruction.
Well...
I would never let that happen. This blade... It chose me. The Rainbow Sage told me it was my destiny to wield it. That with this Yato, I was fated to unlock the Seal of Flames and end this war.
But are you truly worthy? I believe a test is in order. If you are unworthy of wielding the Yato, I will pry it from your dead hands.
It can't be.
What? But you just said we could pass through here safely.
You may, if what you say is true, and you truly mean to bring about peace. If not, the blade will fail you, and I shall take up its noble cause in your stead.
No.
Please, wait. I don't want to fight you.
Don't worry.
Don't worry, Jane. Just show him what you're made of. This battle is no different than all the other ones we've fought and won.
Don't worry yourself.
You can do this. You're stronger now than I ever could have imagined. Your family is behind you all the way. Together we shall prevail.
Huh.
Ho-ho! What have we here? Two more wielders of legendary weapons. The glistening metal of Siegfried working alongside the ancient pages of Brunhildr. This fight will be the stuff of legends. Let me witness the power of those who align themselves with the Yato wielder. I will gather my best soldiers, including one nearly as skilled as myself. Hayato!
I'm right here, Fuga. A child? You expect me to clash blades with a cute little boy?
I'm not a child. I'm a grown man.
I am no child, fool. My name is Hayato. You should thank the gods that you have the chance to face one as talented as I am.
Oh.
Right. Okay, then. He sure is confident for someone so... diminutive. He looks shorter than Elise.
What?
What? What does height have to do with anything, foul beast? Fuga, we're not gonna let her get away with insulting our honor, are we?
If you're that angry, then exact your revenge on the battlefield. You are the most talented mage in the entire village, young one. Unleash your power, and show these outsiders the Wind Tribe's might.
Like I'm even capable of holding back.
Well then, Princess Jane, the time has come. We will be waiting outside the castle. Come find us when you are ready to meet your fate head on.
Yes.
If this is how it must be, so be it. Alright, let's fight, dude. Let's see. Alright, so we're just not bringing Azora again. Because I do want a pair. But I feel it will be nice. Actually, fuck it. Let's bring Azora. We could use her song. Huh. These guys actually have some really nice defense. I should send Charlotte over that way. Oh, and the gimmick of this map. Fuck this gimmick. This gimmick's so fucking stupid. And it appears on Revelation, too, so I'm gonna have to do it again. God damn it. This is a rather nice map, though, without the gimmick. I'm gonna see something, actually. Kana. I'll change with you if I give you an Ebon Wing. Lose HP and strength, but you gain a lot of other stuff. I can also heart seal you into other stuff, can I? Paladin, Great Knight, Spearmaster, Basara. I really feel like making him a Spearmaster. He won't need use for his magic and stuff, but he'll need to grind up his lances. I really want to reclass him into something else, though. Where he'll actually start to get skills. You know what? Let's make you into a paladin. So that way you can start to get the skill. Actually, I want to make you a great knight instead. What's the difference? Defender and Aegis, Luna and Armored Blow. You know what? Yeah, I will make you a paladin, Kana. It might be useful for you to be a paladin. I feel like you'll be more useful as a paladin than a great knight or a noble for now. So now he can use lances too. And I do have a bronze lance. Fuck you, Silas. Give my son bronze lance. I feel that's better for him. Alright, so let's see. I'm definitely sending Kaze over this way. I'm gonna have to take this map slowly, just so I can focus on what I'm doing. How many enemies are there? 30. Jesus. Alright, let's save real quick.
So we can get on with the game.
Okay, so at the end of the enemy phase, any of our units caught in the wind's path will be moved 5 spaces in whatever direction the wind is blowing. Even if you can't tell what direction the wind is blowing, you can tell by the color. If it's orange, it'll move your units down. If it's yellow, it'll move your units up 5 spaces. And if there's nowhere to stand, they're going to be moved to the nearest safe space. So, for example, I'm going to edit this. If your unit is standing, say, right here, and since the wind is blowing up over here, you'll think, oh, 5 spaces up, there's no safe space, so the unit's not going to get moved. No, they're going to get moved all the way over to the other bridge. So, yeah. Like I said, fuck this map. I don't like the gimmick. I can start sending people over this way. Actually, what enemies are in the path? So I can start doing... I can use that to my advantage a little bit. Let's do this. Let's see what happens. Move them down. Move no one else up. Have Azora come over here and sing. Only the spear will be able to reach us. You know what? I'm just gonna keep Xander up front then. Hmm.
Yeah, let's have Jacob weaken this guy a little bit. So Connick coming for the kill. Red Heaven. I love all of Jacob's activation quotes. Alright, stats lowered. Oh, and my strength got lowered too. Kinda can't kill with the lance, but... Oh well. I'm still gonna try to kill with the lance anyway. Even if I know it won't work. I'm some Kaze up here. Just a start on these guys.
Your battle has ended.
Ooh, actually, I just thought of another way to weaken that guy a little bit. Camilla. Yeah, you're doing 8. Don't do that. Savage Blow, too. I forgot about that. So then Kana can come in here, get your weapon experience, buddy. Oh, now you're doing 12.
All right.
Not bad. And Elbow Room. Ooh, doesn't that give you more damage? Yes, +3 damage. That's actually really good for you, Kana. Might as well get a healer down here, so I'm gonna send Shura this way. He's gonna be the one to heal them. Heal my son, Niles. And you get a level 2. What are you, level 9 now? Level 8? Yeah, it's not bad. Let's see, I want him to Effie far, so... These mages down here are gonna be a pain in my ass, I can tell. For now. I'll send Leo down this way too, just in case something comes up. Ow, 3 damage.
Your battle is over.
Yes, it is, Xander. Aw, you're running back. And the winds are back. Well, they can't blow us anywhere over here, so that's fine.
Together.
Atta girl.
I win!
Oh, Xander said let's get a level. Wow, you got resistance, Charlotte. Now, that's something else. Alright. Now, since you're level 8, let's let... Oh, no, you're not doing enough. How much am I doing with a mini bow? 7? God, Charlotte. You know what? For right now... I'm gonna unequip you. I can have Leo come over here. You don't have any activation. So yeah, let's Brunhilder you.
Oh, what a pain in the butt!
And then we can switch back to Xander and Sigrid.
I see.
Not bad. And Shura can heal. How many staves do you have left, Shura?
Yep.
Not bad. Okay, you still have another man stave after that. Let's do this. Because at the end of the... enemy phase that we get moved. Kaze will be moved where? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yeah, that's not too bad. Because all these guys can reach Kaze. And Kaze is going to annihilate all of them. So let's just keep it like this for now. What are they doing? You bastards. You fucking assholes. That is so scummy. Huh. That's such an asshole thing. I'm just gonna shining bow you. So that way Kana can come over here and get his bronze lance. Oh, he has 7 movement now, so I can actually do this. Yeah, that's 34. And you've got Tonebreaker, too. No hope of even hit. Of course, Rend Heaven didn't do anything. What was I expecting?
It had to be done.
Level 9, Kaze.
Leave it to me.
Not bad. Ooh, I don't know if I want to do that. Fuck it. Fuck it, let's see what happens. I'm willing to tempt fate once. Move you up, move you down. Move you up. Okay, that wasn't too bad. You have silence. I don't care. I don't use magic. Oh, that's a notification on my phone. I'll check that later. Yes, now I can move all you guys up. You guys are all magic up there. You give resistance, right? Yes, you do. And you give speed, too. What are you guys at speed? 19? Yeah, you're not. Leo's not going to be doubling, but... Ooh, actually, he might be. Let's move you up here. Yeah, you're gonna double now, Leo. Well, if they decide to attack him. Ooh, they missed their silence. Oh, yeah, they do.
Leave this to me.
You go, Leo.
Was nothing.
Stay sharp.
Was that all?
So close to a level, Leo. Oh, he's still in someone else's range. I didn't see that. Oh. What are you guys doing? No. Bad. You're not supposed to be there. Xander, hit that dragon, man. Move you guys up. Now let's see what happens. I'm willing to tempt it. Yeah!
I had no choice.
God, I love Shura's quotes. Sounds so cool. I had no choice. Oh no, I can't reach. I can't switch him back to a mini bow. Oh well. Alright, Niles. You're up. Oh my god.
Oh, that's it?
Sounded terrible. Even if that had hit, it wouldn't have done anything. Oh, stealing his strength. Oh, you're attacking me because I have 11 sword. Shit! My god. They're trying to move back into position now. Screen. You know what? Dragon Vein. I was even looking at the other ones. This could really backfire. Doesn't it always, though? Okay, no. It didn't. Not in this case. Leo's strength is so fucking bad. Let's see. What do you have? You have Steel Yumi. So you know what? I'm gonna send Shura over here. Xander can't take care of you, but I know someone who can. If that hits her, that's going to be very bad. Okay, good. Lesson learned, Charlotte. I will not underestimate you.
Did I do that?
Oh boy. I should probably take care of that guy. Camilla, you're up.
You may rely on me.
Hey, level for Camilla.
Oh?
That's a pretty good level, actually. Let's see. That priestess is still... Well, you don't have a shining bow, do you? No, you have a Steel Yumi. Yeah, trying to silence Niles. She's going after him, she has good resistance.
Don't come any closer.
Now, Wayne Festal. They're getting back into position still. Oh my god. No, we need to hit a Dragon Vein. Shit. Oh, yeah, we're in your Dragon Vein. Nope. We're not doing this one. I'll let all the enemies move up instead of the ones who are supposed to stay stationary. All you fucks can move up. I'm not doing that. Give me a nice chance to advance too. I should really buy some vulneraries for myself. And a Zora you can move up to. Okay, that bitch is out of silent stabs. Hayato's healing that girl now. And more enemies. Cool. Kaze deal with the mage on Miyoji.
It ends here.
Yes, it does. All right, let's go with the votive candle. Rend Heaven. That's not gonna do anything because you have no strength. Jacob's not killing unless he gets a crit. So that's good. I can save it for Kana. You go, my boy.
This one's not afraid to die.
So close to level 6, Kana. And I'll move me and Effie over here. Let's move out of the wind. Oh, actually, which range am I on? That guy. I'm not even in your range anymore, so I don't have to worry about that. Actually, no, let's do this. Move you out of there, and we can move Charlotte in here. Who really needs to be healed. So, you know what? We're just going to power through it with Xander.
We will not fail.
Yay, level for Kana. Hey, you got speed and magic. Shelter, you don't need that, buddy. Oh, he got his resistance lowered. Oh, not Kana. No, we ain't letting Kana die. Oh, sword. I didn't remember that guy just sword catcher. It's not like doing any damage. Places Xander's good fucking resistance. I mean, defense. No, not resistance. Oh, no, seal defense! Oh, fuck you. That's not fair. God, everyone's moving up now. This is so bad. No, and the wind's popping up again. Fuck. I really feel like doing that. Just say, fuck you, wind. Let's see what happens. Ah, he rent heaven. He rended heaven. I didn't want him to rend heaven, but he rended heaven.
This won't do.
Oh well. Ooh. I just remembered you need to heal. Kana. Someone needs to heal my son. Ooh, actually. No, Hayato doesn't move. Can we just get moved? No. Kana can do this because
reminds me of the old days.
He's oh no, he's not gonna kill Val.
You're lucky I'm here.
Ooh, maybe I should have switched to a different weapon. Ooh, I'm not liking that. You know what, instead of healing Kana, I think it's safer if I just kill you. I can still save Kana. So let's drag in Vayne right now. You up, move all of you down. That helps me in the slightest. Although, hey, there you go, Zora.
Victory is ours.
Wow, strength. Let's do this, see what happens.
I'll do what no one else can. No one beats me.
Attaboy, Shura.
No.
And we can have Charlotte.
Is that all?
The fuck was that? What was that sound she made when she died? No. What are you, Tim Allen? No, I can't even do that ground. Let's move back to position. Oh my god, this fucking wind. Every 5 seconds of the fucking wind. You know, this is a good spot to, get up your resistance. To get your resistance good. Hey, weapon level D, good. Now I can give him, men's staves. Screw it, just have Charlotte kill you.
Together.
So I can hit the dragon van.
You disgust me. I win.
Then we come up here and have Leo hit the dragon vein. Ooh. You have a steel Naginata. And my defense 20. Yeah, sure. We'll do that.
Leave this to me. Failure is no option.
Level 7. Strength. Luck and resistance. Back to their positions. Everyone's getting moved up this time. Not if I have anything to say about it. Well, that's not too bad, actually. I'll do that with Leo and Shura. I'll just sing to get some experience. No. Fine. Let's Dragon Vein then. Let's have Niles grab this chest, too. Rest of Stave. Okay. Jacob. Kenshin right up there, too. I don't know what I'm gonna do with Jacob. Oh, I moved them all up a little bit. No one's in their path. So let's have Kana finish off the priestess.
Age before beauty.
Halfway there to weapon level D. How far can those guys reach? Mark them off so I can see. Let's see. Spearmaster. Kenshin, I should check. Yeah, the Kenshin I can reach everywhere, so I'm not gonna put Camille out on the front lines.
Well, that is a thing. I don't know if Jacob can handle all those attacks, though. Well, I could do this. This might work. Oh my god, he's doing like absolutely nothing. Oh, because you have a guard nugget out of it, that's why. Yeah, fuck you.
9 damage, but you're stealing my strength. That priestess can get me. That's about it, though. Yeah, screw it. Let's go with this. I can get my guard gauge up.
Maybe I get a Rend Heaven. There we go.
I'm afraid this will be messy.
My strength's going down. It's still going down anyway, because I'm using a Silver Dagger, too.
So what am I weakened? 8. Chest now. Dragonstone Plus. Oh, I forgot you healed Hayato. Oh, whatever.
Back off. Time to take out the trash.
Jacobin is 1 damage. Always doing more damage to this chick. Rend Heaven.
You are about to be served.
Oh, so close. Getting moved up by this one. So Kana finish you.
Allow me to join you.
Oh, so close to getting level 7 now. He's grown so much. Let's use Bronze Axe against you. Get F your level.
Here I am.
She's been waiting on this level for a little bit.
Well, that was easy. Am I too strong?
Yeah.
I know someone who's stronger, but not sturdier. Yeah, let's do it in Iron Bow. Oh, so close to a level. Well, I can have him heal Jacob. 10,000 G. I should have Jacob heal too. Yeah, I'm gonna use the Dragon Vein. Pull everyone out a bit. Oh no, you froze Xander. Oh, he's doing 12 times 2 to me. Maybe if I can have Kaze come in and weaken him. Although knowing Kaze, it'll probably kill him. Alright, let's have... Yeah. Those these guys have done enough. It's Effie's time to shine now. Jacob needs to recover his strength. He's currently at minus 12. That's the one downside about using Silver Weapon in this game. The debuffs really stack. No.
Do I have any other treasure chests to open up, or is it just those three? Yeah, it was just those three. Alright. Stop freezing Xander, goddammit. Oh, you have a dual Naginata? That's no fun. You bastard. We only have two freezes left, so that's not a big of a deal. Eight times two, that's... what? That's 16. Unless I get a lethality. So he's doing 16, which brings him down to what? 31, 16.
15. That brings him to 15 health. And then... I don't know if Connor will be able to finish multiple lands, but hey, let's try it. I'm willing to give it a go. I'm willing to give it a college try. Let's get this over with. I have better things to do.
Hey, me too, Hayato. I got more episodes of this shit to record.
You leave me no choice.
Kaze, come on.
At least I'm dying like a man.
Yeah, that's true.
You're stronger than you appear.
Right then. Ooh, none of you guys can actually reach that area over there. I could just have Niles weaken this guy a little bit. Or not. All of Effie's attacks will kill him. You aren't doing anything. You're doing 14. Oh yeah, and you also do that too. So let's have Kana come in for the kill.
Listen to your elders.
Guess I did it right.
Attaboy.
Look, did I do it right?
Why am I reading those? I've never read those before. Defender. Let's get rid of Dragon Fang for now. Because he could use some more stats.
Let's go.
Okay, let's see what happens. Yeah, you're getting frozen again, Xander. Oh, Camille got blown back. No, we're not doing this. Yeah, let's get you a kill with a sword, Leo.
Just my
yes.
Here I come.
I should thank you.
Alright. You have a steel Naginata. Give you a little boost, kinda. Hey, 25, that's just enough to double him. Elise Helipsura.
what? Fuck it. Let's just take care of him right now. 7 times 2. He's getting seal what? Seal defensed? That doesn't make a difference. And he's also in a pillar. Oh, well, he can just walk onto the pillar. And you're just frozen there still. Oh, you're healing him. Fuck you.
Reminds me of the old days.
Ooh, Kana. You go, buddy.
Age before beauty. You're lucky I'm here.
Sorry.
That's almost another level up. They might have to take care of the priestess just because. Ooh, they didn't freeze Xander for once. Fuck you. Freeze me. There we go. And all the freeze staves are gone now. Now that I'm moving back down. Chapter's going a lot more smoothly than I thought. This chapter definitely went a lot more smoothly than I thought it would. Okay, that doesn't matter to me. No? Strength and luck by 1. All right, now you have to be level 15 before you get Aegis. Oh, he's so close to getting that weapon rank increase. I'm so happy for him. Just move a bunch of units around here. Because they get blown at the end of the enemy's turn. That sounds so weird. You guys back. Still have Kana just focus on beating the crap out of this priestess.
You have my support.
I guess I did it right.
Attaboy. Let's see what happens. Oh my god, 29. He's one-shotting Elise. Although I can't say I didn't expect that. What are you still at, Jacob? -6? You're still recovering. Let's see, how much is Kana doing? 3. He's doing 10 with his... You have a lance right now. I could go with Charlotte, try to get a hit, 2 hits off on him. Or she could get a crit and just kill him. Either way, let's see what happens. I'll use the iron axe.
Are you worthy enough to follow she who wields the legendary Yato? If so, prove it.
Don't worry yourself.
I'm gonna tear you in half.
Charlotte!
A shameful.
Oh, I knocked his necklace off.
The power. I see it now.
Hmm.
That's a good level, girl. And a secret book. Alright, we still need to seize. Actually, you're close to level, I'm sure, so let's just do this.
Okay, okay.
And let's seize. Heroes Gunter and Kana, yet again.
Fantastic!
You fought well, Jane, as did your loyal allies. I see now that you are truly worthy of wielding the Yato. Divine Blade chose well.
Do you truly believe that? Thank you. I'm so happy. Why are you smiling like that? You look ridiculous. I'm just so grateful to finally put my own doubts to rest. All this time, I've struggled with the question of whether or not I'm worthy. Whether or not I chose the right path. Whether I can truly use this divine blade to bring peace to the world. For our fated hero, she's so humble. It's odd.
All will be well.
Worry not, young princess. Your power is beyond question, and your aim is true. No matter what path you walk or which kingdom you fight for, I am certain you will always make the right choice and use that blade for good.
Thank you.
Thank you, Fuga.
Suppose I must.
Fine. If Fuga accepts you as a hero, I suppose I must do the same.
Yes.
Thanks, Hayato. I'm glad to hear it.
Listen.
But know that the next time we meet on the battlefield, I won't lose. Divine Blade or no Divine Blade, I won't tolerate a defeat. While you're off saving the world, I'm gonna keep training. When this war is over, come face me again. If you have the guts, that is.
Understood.
I better end this war soon, then. I don't need you getting any stronger. You speak the truth. I look forward to our rematch. Good luck, Jane. May the winds be ever at your back.
Well, then.
Come, Jane. I will show your people the way through our village.
Listen.
Are you ready for this, Jane? We'll arrive at the Hoshiden capital soon. The battles ahead will be our most difficult yet. Prepare yourself.
Yeah.
I'm ready. As ready as I'll ever be. And with that, we will end our episode here. So, next time, on Let's Play Fire Emblem Fates Conquest, we'll be taking on Chapter 21, The Eternal Stairway. I will see you guys then. Bye!